Meteorologists call it the super outbreak.
The United States was assaulted by 148 tornadoes, several of which savaged Kentuckiana.
We looked out the window, and it looked terrible. And I had the baby in my arms, and I walked down the basement stairs, and all hell broke loose.
Wednesday, April 3rd, started like any other spring day. People left homes for school and work, not knowing those homes would not be there when they returned. Kentucky State Police and Weather Service radar reported a tornado near Brandenburg.
Brandenburg took a direct hit about 3 in the afternoon. The town had very little warning and was devastated.
Mr. Markham, a pastor at the local church, had just finished mowing the parsonage lawn, but Betty called him to pick her up early from work.
I left the house at 4:05 and it blew away at 4:08.
Their church, their home, and 18 of their neighbors' lives gone.
The storm struck at 4:12 p.m. and broke the clock. The owner at the time kept this as a memento, a horrible moment frozen in time.
The tornado cut a path 500 yards wide. 31 people were killed, including a number of children who apparently were playing outside after school.
It was so sad.
The destruction in Brandenburg alerted Louisvillians the twister was on its way.
At about 4:25, a tornado was reported to have struck the fairgrounds.
The tornado ripped off a portion of the roof at the Kentucky Fair and Exposition Center, sending debris several hundred yards away.
The Highlands, Cherokee Park, Crescent Hill, Rolling Fields, Northfield, New Market, gone with the wind.
By 4:45, the tornado moved across Jefferson County, ripping up houses and trees.
And I had the baby in my arms, and I walked down the basement stairs and crouched at the bottom of the stairs, and all hell broke loose.
He looked out the window, and it looked terrible. So we went down and we got under the basement stairs.
Went back downstairs for a few minutes, and then when we came back up, everything was just gone.
You leave and everything is fine, and you come, and 6-8 hours later, your whole world is turned upside down.
Oh, it sounded like maybe a million people were marching through the house. I mean, it was just all this noise and commotion. We actually had to climb over trees to get out of here.
Almost as quickly as the tornado had hit, government personnel and volunteers turned out to aid those in need. The National Guard, the Red Cross, city, county, and state workers, telephone and LG&E repairmen, and just people who wanted to help.
We went into several of those houses and we took away closet doors and used them for stretchers to carry some of the people out that were injured.
On that day, 26 twisters hit the Commonwealth, killing 77 people and causing an estimated $110 million in damages.
I still get teared up about it, and that's been so long ago, you know.
I talked to a man in Newmarket. He had just recently moved into his new home in the $60,000 to $70,000 bracket. He's living with friends now, with his wife and children. His home is gone, but his family isn't. His three-year-old was in his second-floor room when the tornado hit. That room is gone now. His child was only slightly injured. I can rebuild the house, he said. I couldn't replace the child. Thank God we're safe. Thank God it's over.